Hi, my name is Nikki Lerzak. I'm the Instructional Services Librarian at Genesee Community College, and this is Let's Look for Articles, searching General OneFile. Why should you look here? Books take time to be written, but articles are faster. They have a much shorter turnaround time. They're usually much shorter than books, a couple of pages, and they're usually very focused. They have a specific point of view and a specific focus that they are writing about. They're not a big general topic overview the way a book is. Databases are bigger. They have millions of articles. Our book catalog can't compete. So if you can't find that the library owns a book on your topic, there is still a very good chance that you'll find articles on your topic. Articles in the databases have built-in authoritativeness, which means they already exist somewhere out there in the real world in print. And before they can exist in print, they've been edited, they've been checked by someone, they've made sure they're not lying and that they are not libeling someone. They can be more trustworthy than a web page, where the web page does not have that level of people scrutinizing it to make sure that it is truthful information. Reputations are important for magazines and newspapers and journals. They want to be trusted. And while everyone out there does have a bias, editors and journalists are not excluded from that, we hope that they try their best to minimize and that they don't put their opinions in print when they're trying to just inform you. However, we know that it's true that people are people, and sometimes journalists do lie and they do make things up. And if you're interested in seeing an interesting case of that, check out the Wikipedia page for Jason Blair, which was a very interesting instance of journalist who was lying. So how do we get to the library's databases? First off, we're going to go to the college homepage. And from the college homepage, we come up here to the library. And when you get to the library's homepage, we want to go to the databases A to Z. So from databases A to Z, you'll see our giant list of databases. And up at the top are all of those tabs, so you could find databases that all have to do with health or history. But down below here is our big alphabetical list. And General OneFile is one of our multi-purpose general databases that cover lots of different topics. What you'll notice when you get into General OneFile is that it defaults to what is known as subject searching. This is that big picture topic search. Usually, you can use the same topic in our book catalog when you come in here. So let's first remind ourselves, what topic have we been searching when we were in the book catalog? And when we were in the book catalog, we were searching the topic of tattoos, and more specifically, whether or not people might face possible job discrimination if they have tattoos. So, and we did a lot of brainstorming here and thought of lots of different words that sounded interesting to us, like body art, piercing, discrimination. These words we will bring with us when we get back to the database. It's best to start obvious. So if tattooing was my topic, it seems like a very reasonable place to go, and we have a nice match. And there are many articles on this. And when a topic has many articles, we usually recommend that you take a look. Make sure that you're in the right place. Is there a better subject? And I see some of the same things that we thought of. There's body art. I also see tattoo artists and tattoo removal. And I've got all of these legal type things mixed in. And you can see over here that it tells me that body art is a broader term and is probably likely to include piercing with it as well. And that there are all these related terms. And over here, I can see how many articles are associated with this concept. But tattooing looked like it worked pretty well. There were a good number of articles. So I'm going to stick with it as my subject. But again, because there are so many articles on it, what we want to do is come over and take a look at the subdivisions. And in this case, the subdivisions, there's lots. Now, this can be a very long list to look through, and learning how to scan this list is a good skill. It tells you at a glance what's important if you know what to look for. The things that jump out for me are numbers. You can see there are a number of subdivisions that do not have a whole lot going on. They have one, they have three, they have five. When I see larger numbers, upwards of 100 to 200, I know that these are the areas that this topic seems to really focus on. They're probably the most important aspects. And I see things like social aspects down here, and I see laws, regulations, and rules, and I see the health aspects. So a lot of the concern for tattoos have to do with being healthy and getting a tattoo. What does society feel about them and the legality of tattoos? If my topic is discrimination, I'm going to be disappointed. There is no subdivision of discrimination. Here's where I have to think, what words would work besides that? Besides discrimination, we know this is job discrimination, but I don't see employment. Discrimination is often based on prejudice. I don't see prejudice down here. Using my vocabulary to think of what are my other options, I do see that there is down here a public opinion. Public opinion is very much like, what do people think about this? But I also know that social aspects, which I've already seen, is a decent subdivision. It has a good number of articles. It is, again, what society feels about tattoos. Social aspects seems like the right place to think about how we feel about people with tattoos working in jobs. Once I come here, now I can see over here on the right-hand side the content types, and you can see that that breaks down across magazines, journals, books, and news, and that it automatically dropped into academic journals, which can be more scholarly and often are a little more intense and research-oriented, but not always. In fact, if you take a look at the first journal article over there, you will see that it's called You Need to Cover Your Tattoos, Reconsidering Standards of Professional Appearance in Social Work. What I will also notice is that above my article, it tells me, first and foremost, that this is a citation, which is not a whole article. Since my goal is to have a whole article, something that I can read, this is the least helpful. It tells me really not very much about it. But what I can find out are the general topics of this article by clicking on its title and then going to those related subjects. And I can see that this article will talk about body piercing and social workers and tattooing. It sounds interesting. It's about a very specific job and the considerations involved with piercings and tattoos and people doing that job. So if I'm interested in it and I would like to maybe hopefully look at it, under publication information, I have Get Full Text down here for the library links. And what that's going to do is check across all of our databases to see if that is a full text article anywhere else. And lucky for us, it really is in a number of places. So all I have to do is choose one of them, and it takes me to that database, and here's my article information again, and over here on the left is the PDF full text of that article, which pops right open for me. And this article is a friendly article in that it's not very long. You will notice that this article is 2 pages of text, but it does go on for longer than that because it includes references, the articles that this article used when they were writing it. It does go on for a while, but a 2-page journal article, that's very friendly. And it does seem like a very interesting article, and it would be a good article for the topic that we're looking for. If we go back to our search results, besides citations, the other types of articles that you can find in here, the ideal, obviously, would be something like this one, which says full text article. This one's not on my topic because I'm not interested in the art of tattoos. I'm much more interested in discrimination and employment. But besides the full text of this article, you also have a PDF, which, just like we saw, looks like a photocopy of the article. This is the goal. This is what we're aiming for. The middle of the road between the citation and the full text is something called an abstract. And an abstract is just a paragraph summarizing what is this article going to talk about. So I have a paragraph to read. I still have those related subjects so that I can see what this article is about. And if I thought it sounded interesting, I can still try and get a copy of the full text. Though in this case, you will notice it is not a possible article that we can get to right now. And in fact, we would have to request it via interlibrary loan, though that is a very easy process. And usually the article comes in just a day or two. It doesn't take long to get to that article. With subject searching, the last thing that I can do, besides limiting it to the subdivision of social aspects and looking at the different types of articles, journals, magazines, and so forth, I can also search within. So if I thought within this category, I'd like to find all of the articles that talk about discrimination, I find that there's not many. There is a journal article and a news article that talk about it, and this one does not look like it's on topic for me at all. So this is not necessarily a good way to go about finding what I'm looking for. The other possibility is to come down here and take a look at the subjects that are also coming from these different articles. Remember when we looked at the related subjects, that's where all of these come from. And these will change based on which content type you happen to look at, because all of the different articles have different subjects associated with them. So I can see that of these 76 magazine articles, 5 of them also talk about piercing. So if I thought, well, I really specifically want to find those articles as well, now I've got just the 5 articles that have both tattooing, social aspects, and body piercing, and these do appear to be much better in terms of hiring issues, piercing is not okay, judging people by their appearance, why getting a tattoo can be risky. These look like they might be much more on topic for me. I can search within the subject search, and I can limit to related subjects for my articles. And that is the best way to go about subject searching in this database.